Ladies and gentlemen, all CEOs, good morning. First, on behalf of Indonesian government and the people of Indonesia, I would like to thank you for your coming to my presentation. Today, I'm very happy to be among with you, because you know, I was a businessman a year ago. So this morning, I'm very happy because we can talk about business, about investment with all of you. The picture show you our map of Indonesia. We have population 240 million, and the distance is like from London in UK to Istanbul in Turkey. And imagine, we have 17,000 island. 17,000 island. Our national budget on 2015 is 167 billion US. And for fuel subsidy is 27 billion US. It's huge. So we want to channel our fuel subsidy from consumption to the productive activity. From consumptive activity to productive activity. We want to channel our fuel subsidy to the farmer for seed, for fertilizers, and also for irrigation. And we want to build the dam, 25 dam in 5 years from our fuel subsidy, to maintain the water supply to the farming area. Some subsidy we want to channel to the fishermen, to give them boat engine, to give them refrigerator. We want to increase the income of the fishermen. Fuel subsidy we want to channel to micro and small enterprise in the villages. We want to help them raise their working capital. And some subsidy we want to channel to the health program, the education program. And the subsidy we want to channel to the infrastructure. In 5 years, we want to build 24 seaport and deep seaport. As you know that we have 17,000 island, so we need seaport and we need deep seaport. And this is your opportunity, 24 seaport and deep seaport. The picture show you our Jakarta Port, Tanjung Priok Port. In 2009, the capacity is 3.6 million TEUs a year. And our plan in 2017 is around 15 million TEUs a year. This is the potential port in Indonesia. This is your opportunity. You want to bid in Sumatra Island, in Kalimantan Island, in Java Island, in Sulawesi Island, in Maluku Island, and also in Papua Island. And we plan to bid our railway track, railway network. Now we have already in Java, and we want to bid in Sumatra Island, in Kalimantan Island, in Sulawesi Island, and also in Papua Island. This is your opportunity. Now we talk about mass transportation. We want to bid our mass transportation in 6 big cities in Indonesia. We have started in Jakarta last year. And we want to bid in Medan, in Makassar, in Semarang, in Bandung, in Surabaya. So this is also your opportunity. Because you know our national budget is limited. Now we talk our maritime agenda. We want to bid CETL. What is CETL? CETL is maritime transportation system to make our transportation costs lower, to make our transportation costs more efficient. We want to bid from the west to the east. We hope not only the vessel can enter our CETL, but also mother vessel can enter the CETL. So the price, the cost of the transportation more efficient. For example, the price of the cement, 1 sack cement in Java Island is $6 per sack cement. But in Papua Island, the price is $150 per sack cement. Imagine, 25 times. So we hope with our CETL, the price in all of the island is the same. Electricity. We need power plant. We need around 35,000 megawatt to build our industry, to build our project, to build our industrial zone, our manufacture zone. So we need power plant. This is also your opportunity to invest in this project. Because we need our power plant for manufacturing, for industrial zone. Many investors, a lot of investors, when they come to me, almost of them, they always complain about land acquisition. I will push my minister, my governor, my mayor to help clearing this problem. I have experience with land acquisition. When I was a governor, we have project Jakarta Outer Ring Road. Started 15 years ago, but it stopped 8 years ago because we had problem here, 1.5 kilometer unfinished because there is 143 family do not accept with the compensation price. So last year, I invite them. I go to the ground and then I invite them for lunch and dinner for time. Ah, this is me. I invite them and then we talk about the problem for time meeting, and the problem is clear. And now the toll road has been used 7 months ago. This. Now we talk business permit. We have national one-stop service. National one-stop service office that can help you, that will serve you, that will facilitate you, that will give you your business permit. For example, a principal business permit need 3 days to process. Finally, again, on behalf of the Indonesian government and the people of Indonesia, I would like to thank you for your listening, my presentation. We are waiting for you to come to Indonesia. We are waiting for you to invest in Indonesia. Thank you. Thank you. Good morning.